Let's head here at home, where the Philippine Central Bank expects November inflation to settle within the range of 4.4 to 4.8%. If that estimate holds up, consumer prices in the said month would be slower than October's 4.9%, but it would still be higher than the government's inflation target for the year. The Banco Central points to lower prices of vegetables and petroleum products, as well as the stronger peso, for its lower CPI outlook. The Philippines' Monetary Authority has hiked its borrowing rates by 450 basis points since last year to help bring down consumer prices. Now we'll see how that forecast plays out on December 5, that's Tuesday, when government releases the official inflation figures for November. A new report sees the main growth driver in Asia-Pacific as moving away from China to South Asia and Southeast Asia. The findings by S&P Global comes as China's economy slows. It now expects India's economy to power ahead in the next 3 years, leading growth in the region. It sees New Delhi's GDP growth hitting 6.4% owing to high domestic consumption. Meanwhile, S&P says other emerging markets such as Indonesia, Malaysia and the Philippines are set to see positive GDP growth this year and the next, also due to strong demand. Global oil prices set for a sixth straight week of decline as voluntary output cuts by OPEC Plus members fall short of market expectations. The cartel of oil-producing nations agreed Thursday to cut production by about 2.2 million barrels per day by early next year. Benchmark oil prices were subdued in Asian trading this Friday after investors anticipated that the additional supply cuts might have been deeper. OPEC Plus, responsible for 40% of the world's oil, is bent on cutting output further as prices continue to fall. On concerns, of course, over weaker economic growth and hopes of a surplus of supply. Back to economic and financial news. Factory activity in Asia remains weak in November with lower global demand, dragging output down. China's Keqin manufacturing PMI unexpectedly rose to expansion territory in the said month, but the same cannot be said for the rest. In Asia's second largest economy, Japan, factory output sank even further, as well as in Australia. Some silver lining, though, in South Korea and here in the Philippines, Seoul and Manila's factory performance improved in November. S&P Global points to solid improvement in factories' operating conditions in Manila, which it says indicated the sector's fastest growth in 10 months. It also says that cost burdens grew at the weakest pace in 3 years. But S&P notes firms exercised a certain level of caution on overstocking, which led to a reduced input buying. Major developments on the war in the Middle East. Israeli forces resume operations against the militant group Hamas after the seven-day ceasefire between the warring sides expired this Friday. Heavy fighting has been reported in Gaza as Israel accused Hamas of firing a rocket from the conflict-hit area. Hamas has yet to comment or claim responsibility for the launch. In the Palestinian side, media there reported to seeing Israeli air and artillery strikes, including in Rafah, near the border with Egypt. The war, which enters its second month this December, has led to thousands of deaths and sparked yet another major humanitarian crisis. In the financial world, it has fueled concerns over a spillover to the entire Middle East and fears of higher oil prices.
The Philippine Bureau of Immigration beefs up its personnel in airports as the Christmas season is expected to bring a surge in passengers. Vivian Gulia joins us now on the line for more on the agency's preparations. Viv, go ahead.
Hi, Denise. The Bureau of Immigration sees around 1.5 million passengers arriving in the Philippines this December for the holidays, nearing pre-pandemic levels. Passengers departing the country this month, meanwhile, is expected to hit around 1.3 million to 1.4 million, according to BI spokesperson Dana Sandoval. In preparation for the expected surge of passengers in airports, the BI added 55 fresh graduates from the Philippine Immigration Academy to man the immigration counters. It also prepared mobile counters for augmentation. The BI encourages passengers to use the electronic gates to fast-track the immigration process. The agency recorded an average of only 7,000 passengers a month utilizing the said facility, noting that it has yet to maximize, or it has yet to be maximized. It plans to procure additional e-gates next year, targeting to cover 25% of the operations. The BI issued assurances that it made corrective measures to prevent excessive questioning in immigration counters, which some offloaded passengers complained about. Tourists, meanwhile, who intended to extend the duration of their visa, now have the option of doing it online. They just have to visit e-services.immigration.gov.ph. Denise, back to you.
Thanks, Viv. Time for some local corporate stories. Meralc Unit MGen Renewable Energy and SB New Energy Corporation enter into an agreement. This for the subscription by MGen of 15.7 trillion common shares and over 19 trillion preferred shares of SB NEC. Leandro Levista's firm has already received an initial payment from the Meralco subsidiary. Meanwhile, Fininvest Land raises 11.4 billion pesos from its fixed-rate retail bonds offer. The property developer says the impressive response to its offer reflects investors' confidence in the company's future. The proceeds will be used to finance its capital expenditure program and repay existing due debts. Finally, Land Bank approves a 20 billion peso loan for ASIN Corporation, which the energy firm will use for the government's renewable energy projects. The state-run bank calls the partnership an important step in supporting the government's pivot to greener and cleaner energy.